Hey, love bugs, how you doing? It's me. Sorry, it's been a while. Mental health and such. Suicidal thoughts, the basics. Yeah. Yeah, sorry about that. I have coffee here. We're doing the next listener. It's Leo again. I don't know. This one's just gonna be random, I guess, because I don't even know what to do anymore. I'm tired. I'm drinking coffee at around 5 in the morning. It's snowing, even though it's April. I don't even know. Global warming. You know how it is. The world is shit. We can't fix it. I mean, we could try, but what's the point anymore? Anyway, yeah. I've got some videos for you. The one that we're starting out with is sad. So yeah, I hope you enjoy that, and then the rest will probably be funny mixed with that. Okay, bye!
I know how you feel.
Don't do that. Please don't do that. You do not know how I feel.
Mike, calm down.
Monsters like you have everything. You don't have to be good. You could mess up over and over again, and the whole world loves you.
Mike.
You'll never know what it's like to fail.
But you're moving so carefully. Let's start living dangerously.
Computer, activate the asteroid defense system! What do you mean, no? Can you at least tell us if it's gonna blow up?
No.
No, it's not gonna blow up?
No.
Then what good are you, you stupid robot?
I missed you. I missed you too. Once I'm done reloading, I'm not gonna miss you again.
Do it, you fucking bitch. I swear to God, I will fucking kill you.
Get that piece of shit ain't moving, you fucking nut, you fucking pansy.
We're not here to fight. We need your help.
Even though literally every time we talk to you, you double cross us, kidnap us, or threaten to destroy everything we love.
Maybe we are here for a fight.
So, yeah, like I said, I don't know what I'm gonna conquer up in my mind. Also, I'm sick, so fantastic. Let's say you were over for a sleepover. Yeah, that seems about correct. So you were over at the brother's house. Well, not house, more like the sewer, but whatever. We're gonna say house because fuck me. I'm tired, I don't care anymore. You're having a sleepover at their house. Mikey really wanted you to have sleepover. Mostly because he've never really had a sleepover with them before. But also, you've told Mikey that you've had feelings for a certain turtle. A turtle in blue. And so, he wanted to spice up the night. You know, like, get you to confess your feelings and such. So, hooray. And you didn't know his plan. He knew. No one knew his plan. Of course no one knew his plan, because why not? But you thought something was suspicious with Mikey once he asked. You could see a glamour in his eye and his expression changed once you said yes. So, yeah, you got your stuff from your house. Leo went with you because Michelangelo said everyone else was busy. You know? And Leo wasn't, so might as well go with you, right? Again, suspicious. Sus. I'm sorry. But, yeah. Then, once you got your stuff, you decided to sleep on the couch. Even though Mikey insisted with you sleeping in Leo's room, you refused because you thought that would be weird, and also you have a bigger fat-ass crush on the blue turtle. Leo also thought it was weird, so yeah, not going well to his plan so far, but he is not a person to give up. So, you and Leo are kind of like the same person in this. You both have insomnia. Welcome to the club if you're new. I have a problem, okay? Don't judge me. Anyway, so you couldn't sleep and you decided to make some coffee, because why not? Hey, look at me, I got coffee. And you saw Leo coming out of his room, also getting to make coffee. So, ha ha ha, yay. Hmm? Oh, hey, hey listener, what are you doing? Ah, making some coffee. That was doing the exact same thing. So, how you been? That's good. I've been alright fighting the foot and, you know, basic stuff. So, yeah, it was kind of extremely awkward, especially after the Krang incident. Because after that, Mikey told you the whole entire thing. You didn't feel awkward or sad or anything. You kind of just like, oh boy. Oh no. Hot dog. Oh. Kind of just, slowly died of relief. But yeah. And little did you know, Michelangelo kept his two other brothers awake. So while you and Leo were chatting it up, I guess, he bursts in with his two brothers and say, how about we play Truth or Dare? You both, and around this time you already made your coffee, so you immediately drop your coffee out of shock. Same with Leo, and yeah, there's no more coffee. Oh, my coffee. Mikey. You know not to do that, especially at the middle of the night. Sorry, I got really excited. Anyways, who wants to play Truth or Dare? Before Leo could protest, you immediately said yes and dragged Leo to the living room, where y'all's played Truth or Dare. So, of course, Michelangelo went first and asked you, listener, Truth or Dare? You decided to pick Dare, because you were kind of on the rebel side. Ah, I see. What do I have today? Let's say with the Leo, not Leo, Mikey that I would know, he would be, why did I say I know? I don't know anyone named Mikey. I don't know. But the Mikey that I am thinking he would be, you get what I mean. With him, I feel like he would be a sweetheart, except when it comes to brutal games. Like spin the bottle, board games, video games, especially Truth or Dare. Because he would call you out on truth, and he would give you a brutal dare. One to either embarrass you, humiliate you, which are kind of the same thing, but whatever. Or just straight up make you, you know, I don't know. Just make you very uncomfortable. Not in the bad way, but in the funny haha way. But yeah. I dare you to kiss Leo on the cheek. And he gives you that smirk. Once he gives you the smirk and gives you the dare, you knew exactly what his plan was. Oh boy, here we go. Leo and you got flustered, and you look over at him. You did ask Mikey if it had to be on the lips. Mikey was cruel, but he wasn't that cruel. It doesn't have to be on the lips. It could be on the cheek, hand, neck, other places. Ew, Mikey. What? They can kiss anywhere, it doesn't matter. But you don't have to say it like that, little brother. You guys are no fun. Yeah, because you're the little brother, you shouldn't be knowing that. But, oh, come on! Yeah, whatever. Anyways, listener, let's get over with the dare, alright? So, you decided to go for his hand. So you lift up his hand and give him a kiss on his hand. Alright, now it's your turn, listener. And you immediately point at Raph and give him a truth or dare. The night goes on with you playing truth or dare, and then Mikey decides, I have an idea. It might be weird, though. So, there will only be listener. None of us are allowed to pull anybody else, okay? They'll only have to pull. What are you referring to, little brother? I'm referring to 7 minutes in heaven. But none of us get the pole. What? I'm asexual, sense actually. Alright, so let's put our belongings in here. So they put their masks in there, and you put a bracelet that your mother gave to you, or father, or sister, or brother, or whoever you want it to be. Or it could be a necklace. You know. You just put something that's valuable to you in the hat, or basket, or whatever. And they hand you the bat. Of course, you draw from the basket, and you get Raph. Ooh. Alright, go in there. Go, 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 go. And the thing is, you've never played 7 Minutes in Heaven, neither did Raph, so you two didn't know what you had to do. No one really explained the rules to you guys, so you kind of just sat there and chat for a bit. Maybe talk about Squishmallows or something. I don't know. Anyway, hold on. Sorry, let me just die real quick. But yeah. You guys just talk about something. I don't know. It could be about dogs, cats, Squishmallows. I don't care how weird Leo is. But yeah, you can talk about anything. Doesn't matter. 7 minutes was up. You guys get out. And then you were left to draw again. You had to put Raph's masks out, so you didn't have to pull him again. So you draw, and oh, it's Leonardo. Alright, get in there, you two. They close the door and they lock it. Excuse me, damn. That was a burp. But yeah, Mikey puts you in the closet and locks it. Don't ask where the closet is. I don't care. But yeah. He puts you in the closet and, I don't know, with some voodoo magic. He locks it from the outside, so it's just you and Leo. Alright, so I guess we should get this over with. And this closet is not big, but neither is it small. Like, it's big enough to fit 3 people in there at best. So, yeah, you had plenty of room. So he pins you against the wall and lifts up your chin with his 3 fingers and was about to kiss you before you stop him and ask him what he's doing. This is part of 7 minutes in heaven. I was about to say 3 minutes in heaven. Oh, only if it was that simple. Oh, I'm so stupid. But he says this is part of 7 minutes in heaven. Wait. Do you not know how to play 7 minutes in heaven? Oh my god. So you never played this game and no one explained the rules to you, never, and you've never heard it? Well, that's a new one. You give him a glare, and he says, alright, alright, I'll explain. Basically, 7 minutes in heaven is where you kiss the opponent and make out with them. Did you do that with Raph? You shake your head, no, you guys just talked about something. I don't know. You can say whatever you like. So, yeah, neither did you or Raph know how to play this game, but Leo did. Don't even ask how. He's a little fruity boy.
Fuck you, okay? Just go with it, alright?
Anyway. Anyway. Coffee break. So, of course, he explains what the rules are, and you immediately flush red after, like, hearing the whole thing. So that's what it is. So, do you want to get this over with, or... You say you're not sure, and he says, alright, we can pretend we did. What do you want to talk about? So, for the next 3 minutes, you guys decided to talk about, random stuff and such. And then, once it got to, after 3 minutes or so, you look down to the floor, and you tell him something. What do you mean? No, I don't really like anybody. As a friend, yes, but other than that, April is not really a love interest at all. I've had my eyes set on a different person. So, yeah. And, they are nice and sweet and beautiful, beautiful eyes that I could drown in. Beautiful smile, beautiful lips, beautiful hair. Overall, the beautiful in general, or handsome. Sorry, I got it. Oh no. And I've always wanted to tell them that. He looks at you with compassion. Love. And you get what he means by all those things. He meant you. Listener, never mind. Do you might wanna... Did you just... Well, and I thought I would be the first one to make a move. Wow, is it hot in here, or is it just me? I mean, I am hot. Well, you're hot too. I mean, well, I love you, listener, with all my heart. Do you maybe wanna kiss again? Because that really felt good. And I felt right to kiss you. It's fine if you don't. It's just your lips look so divine. They look so adorable. I just can't help it. Yeah, I guess you could say that. So, for the next, I don't know, 4 minutes. You wanna kiss some more for the next 4 to 3 minutes, I guess? Or do you wanna just talk? Kiss? Yeah, that feels like a better idea. I love you so much. God, I love you. So, I'm not gonna do that for 3 minutes. One, I can't keep track of time. And two, yeah. So after like 3 minutes or so, Michelangelo opens the door to tell you time is up. So yeah. Hey, time is up. Wow, you really got busy. Yeah, I guess we did. Can you just give me 4 more minutes? But wait, that's not how the... Of course he closed the door on me. Anyways, you guys want to play video games? Sure. Sorry. I meant to do Donnie. Fuck. Sure, I guess. Sure, why not? I got nothing better to do. That's supposed to be Raph. I'm terrible at doing Raph's voice, especially while I'm sick. So, yeah. Why did I close the door? Because I needed a few extra minutes with you. Because we're not done here yet. Baby. Alright, I hope you enjoyed that one for 7 minutes in heaven. Oh boy, I am almost done with my coffee. Oh my god, there's so much caramel. What the fuck? Anyways, hope you enjoyed this. I'll see you in the next one. Give me a minute. Sorry, I'm dying slowly on the inside. But anyway, hope you enjoyed this. We'll see you in the next one. Bye, love bugs!